dedicated members of the Councillors League, distinguished guests, my beloved countrymen. Alam mo, I do not deliver speeches. I just want to converse with the crowd. I have here about 3 pages. I can finish this in about a minute and a half, then we go home. So, parang wala akong mensahe. It's the, well, of course, in fairness to the guy who prepared this, maybe I'll just read the first paragraph. Para naman hindi magagalit yung tao. We in government have already accomplished many things since last year. We have relentlessly pursued our campaign against illegal drugs, criminality, and corruption. It is noteworthy that the PCL complements our initiatives to eliminate these social cancers from our system. Let me just stress, hindi naman ako nagpapakalis. But when I ran for the presidency, I limited the issues to about 4 or 5. And foremost was really corruption. Then the drugs, which was choking us, para tayong sinasakal, and then criminality, and of course the opportunities for economic movement. Alam mo, I'm talking to you as a mayor, probably as a vice mayor. Huwag ninyo akong isiping presidente, for frankly, ang ugali ko hanggang ngayon, pati yung pananalita, never graduated to the level of a statesman befitting a president. Hirap ako mag-adjust, and I do not think I will improve in the next 10 years. Hanggang dito lang talaga ako, and I just have to contend with my mouth and my behavior. Sabi ko, I think that when I filed my certificate of candidacy, I thought all the while that I was just seeking a political position. I never aspired to be a statesman. Mahirap yan. Hindi ka na makapag-chika-chika ng mga magagandang babae. Alam mo, do not be offended. Hindi tayo dito to. Binata ko. I mean, I'm legally separated from my wife. Most of the time, I'm hunting for a wife. But I remember, kasi nung nalaman ko na dalaga na rin siya, without offending the family and everybody, I thought all the while na sinabi ko sa kanya, Ma'am, pwede kitang ligawan? Sabi niya, hindi. Iba lang, wag ikaw. Sige. Kaya kung every time makita kami, I pay my respects and do not attach malice into it. I'm just into it also. Mag ganito yan. Listen to me as mayor. Because someday, most of you will make it to the mayorship. And probably, a lot of you, vice mayor. Alam mo, wala kasi akong ibang example, the template of what local governance should be. But ang pinaka mapakita ko lang, the very yung visual would be Davao City. And do you know that Davao City is ang growth rate 9% the highest. And kung nakita ninyo yung Davao City, I suggest next time that you hold your not a paradise, but at least ang mga tao doon comfortable. Hindi masyado haras. There is no rampaging criminality and drugs is at its lowest. I hold it as an article of faith that no progress, wag na yung national, maraming resistance, no progress and development can take place pag ang lugar mo magulo at maraming krimen. Tandaan ninyo yan. Ang una kong ginawa was really to improve on the law and order. And I was quite a bit strong in my language as I am up to. And I said that those of you who are trying to destroy the city, if you continue to plunder the citizenry and the community, I will just have to kill you. And those of you who insist on doing drugs here, kidnapping, I will kill you. That was my sloganeering. And it has kept the peace up to this time. I was able to talk to my brother Muslims, Moro community. Then I have always been in good terms with the left, so I initiated talks dito sa Communist Front at yung mga legitimate aspiration for a correction of the historical injustice committed against the Moro people. Let me stress that ito lahat keeps us busy now. Terrorism, I just lost 4 policemen again sa Bansalan kanina. It's a boundary municipality towards Kidapawan, North Cotabato. Namatayan na naman daw ako ng 4 na police. And every day I lose soldiers to drugs in Central Mindanao. Kung mag-raid ng laboratory doon, they have to face machine guns, M60. And that is why I cannot have lost count of the many soldiers, hindi lang kasi encounter ng papalabas eh, but drugs connected because the police is unable really to pursue a honest to goodness campaign hanggang a relentless one. It cannot be. So from to time lang na yan. But as president, I again reiterated my slogan. And I said that if you're trying to destroy the Philippines, I will just have to kill you. Kasi ayaw naman kayong maniwala. And if you continue with the drugs, same. But I am facing so many allegations. Some are invented, but some are true. Walang problema yan. I admit many died along the way for the 23 years of a mayor, but never was a time that I executed a person kneeling down or with his hands bleeding. Hindi naman talaga pwede yung gano'n. Parang hindi kalalaki. So I am ready to go to jail, rot in there, for the right charges and for the right punishment. Huwag naman yung lahat itapon sa akin, pati basura, garbage, pabalik-balik. Well, I have consistently refused to answer because pabalik-balik na lang kasi it's been the norm of conduct of the opposite side. Wala ka nang magawa eh. So, except to shut up. Otherwise, sabi nga ni Lincoln, and I said, my favorite adage, that if sabi ni Lincoln, and it is good for you to remember that, if I were to try, and I quote him, if I were to try to read much less answer all attacks made on me, this shop might as well be closed for any other business. I do the very best I can, and I mean to keep doing so until the end. If the end brings me out all right, what is said against me won't amount to anything. But if the end brings me out wrong, 10 angels of God swearing I was right would make no difference. So yan lang ang tandaan ninyo sa trabaho ninyo. Hindi mo kayang sagutin lahat. Pag mayor ka na, o baski kayong in your level as counselors, there will always be allegations of what not. Attacks left and right. But ang mabuti lang kasi dito, if you really want to do it, you have to be clean. Kaya dito sa kampanya ko, tinutuo ko lang kung ano yung sinabi ko. If you remember, even during the debates, my talk was short. And I was very precise because I realized very well at the beginning that you cannot expound about your person or about the issues in government for just 1 minute and a half. Talagang alam ko na kukulang ka. So bulit lang ako. Ito ang gawin ko. I will stop corruption. And I will do it. And as a matter of fact, I am really focused on sa corruption. Dito sa amin, sa taas, I assure you that yung mga cabinet members are clean. But yung sa mga agencies na, alam naman natin, kayo alam ninyo yan, corruption abounds. And even sa local government, pinakamarami dyan. Bantay kayo dyan. And you know how it is. So alam na ninyo yan. Just para pagdating mo sa panahon mo, you can talk about corruption without batting an eyelash. Hindi ka na kailangan mahiya. Wala kang reservations. Because ganyan talaga ang trabaho dapat ng isang presidente. Then about drugs. Pakinggan mo ako, ha? Sinong abogado dito? May I just know the lawyers here? Dito? Lawyers, abogado, kagaya ko. Ang revised penal code, ang ating penology, the criminal system is based on malice or negligent or negligence. Yan lang dalawang yan. Bantay ka dito, ha? Ngayon, ang droga umabot ng epidemic and it has afflicted 4 million people. 4 million Filipinos consigned to being slaves to a chemical yung shabu just to fatten the pockets of the few. Ngayon, yung iba dyan, 40% of the total barangay captains of the entire Philippines may tama sa Cebu. About 6,000 policemen. Cebu has the highest rate of, hindi nila alam to for the first time sinasabi. Mag-abot siguro ng, sabi ng nandyan sa loob, but I think it's about 60-70. Mahirap tanggalin ang pera. Yung mga municipal mayors, yung iba, marami ring mga konsehal, municipal councilors, are into it. Alam mo bakit? Madali eh. Pumasok ka ng droga, overnight, while other people would tirelessly toil for 10 years to earn their first million. If you ask the Taipans dito, when was the first time that you earned the billion? they will give you a figure of something like 10 to 20 years. Shabu, you cook it overnight, and in 2 months, you are a millionaire, but at the expense of your fellow human being. Ngayon dito sa revised penal code, may 4 million. Palagay na natin, lagay mo na ng 500,000 are really bangag na. Ngayon kung itong 500,000 spread all over the country would commit rape with homicide, robbery with rape plus homicide, complex crime, kung anong pinakahinos, murder by explosives, kung itong 500 at 4 million, ratio na lang natin, place it about 800. Kung itong naka-spread all throughout the Philippines, and they commit crimes, anong ginagawa ng judge? Ngayon, abogado man tayo. Then the prosecution would prove na may malice yan. But alam mo, malice excludes persons who are insane. They cannot be held accountable for their act simply because they are not in the right track. Itong Shabu ngayon, look at the danger sa Shabu. Kung magkalat ito, may marunong ang abogado, he does it with forensics plus the testimony. Doctor, do you think that at the time he was aware that he was committing a crime? Sabihin ng doctor, at that time when a person is bangag, he does not know whether it is right or wrong. So acquitted lahat yan. Think about that. Ang umpisa, Shabu. You cannot send him to prison. If I were a lawyer and you pay me enough, I will call in the experts. I would just place them in the stand and say, do you think there was malice? Malice is right and wrong. Do you think that he was conscious of what he was doing? Do you think that he was realizing at that time that it was wrong to rape, to kill? Kaya sabihin, may nagbulong sa akin, demonyo. Ganun talaga ang nangyayari siya po because long term siya po, about 1 year, shrinks the brain of a person. Alam ninyo yan because you are representative of the official dom, one of the largest municipal councilors, excluding the barangay na, which is the basic unit in our country. Alam ninyo yan. Now, 4 million is 4 million. Sabi sila na may mga matay dito ilan. Well, sabi ko, ako, I'm ready to go to prison for the right accusation and the right penalty. Walang problema yan. I gave the orders. Go out and hunt for them. Arrest them if it's still possible. But if they resist violently, placing your life in danger, shoot and shoot to kill. Inuulit-ulit ko na yan. Kasi ganun talaga ang bangag lumalaban. At alam ninyo lahat na kayo nakakaalam, pag nasa droga, yung nagpapabili, may armas talaga. Kipalti kung ano, but he is always armed. He does not loiter around with parang naked na. Alam ninyo yan. Kasi baka yung tayo, may mga nalaman kayong tao sa lugar ninyo, baka kilala ninyo, and the way they behave, and the way they answer kung may tama na. And what ails the system now? One is that the immediate dysfunction of a family. Maghiwalay talaga yung asawa, hindi makatiis. Ipagbili lahat, tapos dahan-dahan, mainit ang ulo. Sometimes, battery. Bugbog ng anak, bugbog ng asawa. And there are thousands of them going on. Separation of families, the breakage of family ties, the cost of shabu. Sinasabi ko sa inyo yan. At 200% more, that is 6,000 a month. Times 3 million, wag na yung 4 million sa akin. Itong 3 lang noon kay Santiago, firm niya, Pedea. At 3 million, that is 18 billion a month. Times 12, that is 216 billion a year. That is the cost of ship. At ipalabas mo na kung mamatay yan, puro inosente ang mga putang ina. They are pictured as victims of injustice na basta pagbabarilin mo lang. Sino ba namang gustong pumatay? Yan ang problema. Because the victims are treated to be saints. Or at least the innocents in the society. When you go after the drug, you have to destroy the apparatus. You cannot stop the apparatus from moving if you do not kill the drug lord and take care. Sabi nila, puro mahirap yan. Wala na tayong magawa eh. Naghihintay siguro yan sila mag-recruit ng mga milyonaryo. Wala namang mayaman mag-standby dyan sa lugar mo, sa munisipyo mo. Yung talagang mahirap, yan nga ang problema. So, what do you... We have to destroy the apparatus. It means people kill. Wala talaga tayong magawa. Otherwise, kung ito lang ang tapusin mo, nandyan ang stock, naghihintay lang yan na may runner mag-apply. Itong mga runner naman, kung makuha lang makuha dito, kasi tapusin mo talaga. That is how it is. You cannot stop the movement of drugs in the entire country. Pag hindi mo yariin, lahat, whether arrest, and there are plenty every day, or people are killed. So, bakit ba? Yun nga ang sinabi ko. I am just complying with my promise. Kaya yung mga taga Maram, it's about 92 LTO pati sa LTRB, wala na. I fired them, pero hindi ako nagpa-publish mo. Basta umalis ka na lang. And even somebody who was with me since 1988, when I made it to the mayor. The first whiff. Makaamoy lang na ano. Hindi na talagang sabihin mo makita ko. You go out. Because I have said to come up with what I have promised. Now, I would not have stressed the drug as number two or the number one problem. Wouldn't that really something which could destroy the country? At alam ninyo, amay may tama niyan ang mga bata. Ang kakawawa yung mga anak sa mga pamilya. And there are thousands. So 4 million na family home, sira na yan. You cannot live with an addict. If your son or daughter are into it, you have a serious problem in the family forever. At yung drain sa finances, yung mga mayaman paying 500 a month just to... At sabi naman ng mga doktor, pag tinamaan yan, when the brain has rung, there is no way of returning it back to its normal size. And then, verily, inutil na yan. So, I am mad, galit ako. Maraming slaves na wala ng silbi. Mabuti pa yung slaves that you buy in the slave markets of the Middle East and Africa, the continent itself. It's a brisk selling of trafficking of human being. At least, mapakinabangan mo, pag nabili mo, pautusan mo, magtrabaho ka. Itong mga anak natin ngayon, what do we do? Pag inutil na, you have lost a son or daughter to drugs, you have lost them forever. Yan ang masakit. Kasi hindi anak nila ang tinamaan. Madali magsalita. Madali magyaw-yaw. Pero kung nandiyan kayo, ibigay ko nga sa inyo, kayo na ang magpatakbo. Ayaw ninyong maniwala itong boulevard. Umunin ko kayo ngayon. Nandito na lang man kayo sa Manila. Magpasyal kayo doon sa inner cities, sa likod niya. From galing doon hanggang dito, I would not mention the names. Sige nga. Pag sinabi ninyo malinis ang daan, wala kayong naengkwentro, mag-resign ako bukas, putang ina. You know, if you ask me if I'm happy being president now, no, I am not happy. I do not need it at this time of my life. I can go anytime. Takot-takotin ako ng ouster, my God. Uy, halika dito. I will swear you. I, being the substitute, will run this country. Fine. Uwi na ako sa amin kasi matanda na ako. Magtingin na lang ako ng mga magagandoon. Ano palang gawin mo? Kung wala namang girls din, buti pang mamatay. Eh kayo, bahakak. Kaya nga tayo nandito sa mundong ito eh, kasi may nanay tayo pati tatay na. Kaya huwag naman yung sobra-sobra. Mga tatlo, apat, tama na. National pala to. Narinig ang dalawang asawa ko. Nabuang na. So economic front, I think I made the correct decision. You know, I went alone sa foreign policy. Then I went to China and talked to President Xi Jinping. And I said, I come here in peace. I am not here to demand or impose some conditionalities. Just want to shake hand and I want to make friends with you. Kasi yung trade ng Philippines pati China, maraming restrictions. Pag nagalit sila, ito saging. Would you believe it? And you can check it. Dublado na lahat ang ating trade sa kanila. Pineapple, dublado. Mango, dublado. Sabi nila, avocado, bilihin namin. Anong pang gusto ninyong bilihin namin? Kasi kailangan namin yan with 5 billion people going 6. There's a lot of people who'd like to eat. Kulang pa yan. So, the Minister of Commerce was kind enough to visit us. And he said, yung mga listahan ninyo previously, it na yun. So, it amounted to $10 billion. Right away, he handed to the finance people $100 million. And another $100 million for Surigao. Kita mo kung magbigay ng aid? $1 billion, hindi pesos. Kaya ganun na lang ang pasalamat ko. And they have really lightened up the economic life of our country. Ang sabi niya, it was a cold winter. It is springtime for you to embrace with us. Kita mo? Noon kasi, parang alangan. Yung mga saging natin, alam niyo mga trader, alam ninyo yan. Kumina kasi may mga restrictions sa quarantine and all of these things that would make really very hard for you to trade. Ang statistics namin, and it was the finance people who told me, Dominguez, that dublado na lahat. And they are willing to buy anything that we can sell. And may mga grants tayo. And they will take care of itong railway from north to south. And we will begin immediately. Kita mo yung sincerity talaga ng Chinese. So, let me publicly again thank President Xi Jinping and the Chinese people for loving us and giving us enough leeway to survive the rigors of economic life in this planet. Kaya ako ta, sabi ko, well, at the expense of being hated doon sa ibang lugar, eh okay lang yan. Total, at the day's end, I am answerable to you dito lang. Kasi kayo lang ang nag elect at magbinisay nga. Tuboy is elected. Ang Pilipino lang man ang nag-elect sa akin in this country. So I answer to you only. I am not obliged even to answer anything from these idiots. Wala akong pakialam sa inyo. Tapos gusto pa akong kulungin ng mga siraulo. Internal. They want to, America, want to hail me before the International Criminal Court. Nagbasa ako, hindi pala membro ang buang. Pati yung hindi ko, ako, yung pinatay ng police, maybe in excess of that duty, or maybe whatever, something went wrong, I am ready to assume full criminal liability. Order ko yan eh. So I have to defend the police and the military for doing it. I am ready to go to jail for the right crimes and for the right punishment. Ba't huwag mo akong tapunan ng basura, ipasagot mo sa akin, Jesus Maria Joseph. Papalag ako diyan. Alam ko, kasi abogado ako, hindi naman ako buang, sinabi ko, I assume full liability. Walang problema yan. Ako ang nag-utos, ako ang sasagot. Period. Walang dihini ha. Pero ngayon, kung abutin kayo sa mayorship, someday, yan lang man ang pag-usapan natin, eh, politika. Alam ko sa inyo, nagpa-plan mo na kayo. Either ambusin si mayor o si vice mayor. Kung minsan, inaagawan ninyo ng girlfriend, kaya mainit. So yan ang advice ko. So I'm not delivering any speech. I prefer just to talk to you. Para ma-realize na rin na kung hindi kayo tutulong dito, hindi talaga malutas itong bayan na ito sa totoo lang. I cannot perform miracles. Well, nigh impossible to do it. Pero kung kayo mismo, as a citizen, kaya kung ako, may baril ako. Marami akong baril. If I were just a civilian, and you are lurking within the neighborhood, at namatay ang babae kong anak na rape mo o ang anak ko na natamaan sa droga naging bangag.
Bibigilantehin talaga kita.
I will be a vigilante.
Hihiritan talaga kita.
Kung wala nang magawa yung polis, hindi na makontrol. And look at ito, the previous crime rates. Bata nire-rape, lolo hinahatsa, nakakita siya ng demonyo, utos ng anghel niya, kung ano-ano lang ang... So, ang problema nga, marami yan. Mas marami pa siya nakaupo dito ngayon. Just give you a visual. Kung kasing dami doblado, you're about mga 5,000. I'm placing it about 8,700. Or you get to a meager amount of 500. I-times mo ito, karami. Nakakalat yan sa buong Pilipinas. And every time they commit a serious crime, the lawyer would just say, Your Honor, we are presenting evidence today to show that my client is insane. And it was caused by shabu. And as the forensics people say, his brain has shrunk. And therefore, he does not know whether what is right and what is wrong. And therefore, there is no criminal liability. What will now happen to this country? Who will answer for that? Sila ba? Who will now take care of those? It's government and the country, taxpayers. Kaya, terorismo, well, some other time. NPA, well, sabi ko, ayaw kong putay ng kapwa ko Pilipino. It grieves me to hear na may namatay ditong apat na NPA na sundalo, anim, Abu Sayyaf, who am I? You think it will make me happy to sign even a document to buy bullets to kill Filipinos? That is why I have gone out. Whether you like it or not, you carry the message. We have to go into a federal system. We have to revise our constitution because it has not worked for the Filipino for many centuries. Tayong taga-probinsya, alam naman ninyo, ano ang nakukuha natin? Buhay pa naman yan si Aquino pati si Arroyo. I govern Davao, hindi ako naghingi ng... Tanungin mo sila. On my own, though I supported Aquino and President Arroyo, hindi talaga ako, hindi ako napunta ng Malacañan. Ayaw ko. Part of my behavior. But I just on my own. Hindi ako I do not make any imposition sa... Pero kailangan natin ayusin ang bayan. Sa panahon ko hindi ito maayos, it's the time for fixing. You know, I have a very simple question. Bakit ka masyadong mainit sa droga? No. It's a part of the game. Part of my duty. As mayor, I build a city. As president, I build a country. Yan ang hindi nila naintindihan. It's not because yung mainit ka, extrajudicial. No. Pangkaraniwan lang yan, buhay mo. E let's say ka, pumasok ka dyan. I do not demean life, but I have to think of the higher interest. And my term as president begins and ends with public interest. Only, nothing else. So I will now demand bitawan ninyo yung droga at tomorrow wala na talagang patay. I will see to it na wala nang patay. Ni isa, huwag kayong mag-corruption kasi pagdating, you cannot come to me for help. Pagdating sa corruption, sorry. Ngayon, kung tulong ang gusto ninyo, maghati-hati tayo. As President, I said, I never favored any region, province, or city. Divide the money as equally as it can be. Yan, kasi puro tayo Pilipino. So, magingay kayo, maraming pera ang syala. Baka balang araw magdatingan talaga. We will sit with that project coming from the help of the government of China and people will be allocated for everybody, including the Sulu area. At mauna sila because gusto ko buksan ang trade barter uli doon sa Sulu, Tawi-Tawi down to Sabah. Ang problema ko ngayon, baka lahat ng mga negosyante, magtatinga yan eh. Kausapin ninyo yung Abu Sayyaf, kaya baka kidnapin lahat na, naluko na. Hindi, kung may pera tayo, bigyan na natin kapital, magnegosyo na lang tayo. Total noon, nung nadyan pa yung trade, barter trade, maganda man ang buhay ng mga tao. Walang Abu Sayyaf, walang terorismo. Well, the usual, and the thousands were really peaceful. So in Central Mindanao, yan ang unang gawin ko, pero I have to get the assurance that everybody is safe and it would be a working arrangement for all. And if not, kung marami na tuloy ang mga disgrasya, pupugutan pa ng loko na. Mag-usap tayo para maangat tayo. I'm willing to talk to anybody about peace. Kasi just to save lives. Hindi nga maganda yan, magsigilan tayo patayan. For what? But the military is there, still there to take care of those who ayaw ng gulo. Yung may mga ambisyon naman na I'll be talking bukas sa Central Mindanao governors and mayors. And for everybody, may I address myself to every mayor. See to it that your municipality or city is peaceful. Alam mo, pag hindi, kukunin ko yung pulis sa kamay mo at papasukin ko na lang ang military with the police. And for the military leader there, hindi man Marcelo, to plan out what is good for a peaceful city or municipality. But I can do that because I have declared the state of lawlessness and the fact that the military is there helping the police to preserve. At the end of the day, lahat tayo, ako I swore that I will protect the people and defend the constitution. Huwag mo na akong pakitaan ng martial law, suspension of date of the episode. Hindi ko kailangan. Dala-dala ko na. My oath of office carries with a simple mandate. I will protect and defend the Filipino. So, in a nutshell, what is it? That I have the sworn duty to preserve the Filipino nation. Hindi ko na kailangan yung Marcelo Marcos. I will do what I think is legally allowable and just do it. Hindi ko na kailangan yun. Krista Duterte mag-Marcos to perpetuate. Anak ka nang ako mag-ambisyon ng perpetuation. Sinabi ko nga sa inyo eh, kung mayroon lang dyan, sige, kayo na. Para ba naggago na mag, what, presidente ka ba, hindi mo na kaya? Eh ngayon pa lang, sabi ko, I am not happy because of the enormity of the problems and I am getting old every day. Mabutit na lang, every time na makakita ako ng maganda, medyo bumabalik ako sa edad pababa. Kagaya nga, kita ko sa Mayra, so to my age has gone down to about 2 years a little bit. So from 72 this month, I'm around 69. pag nakita ko siya. You give me another lady there na simsira na mata ko eh. Hindi masyado makikita. But if there's another lady, I'd like to meet you. And thereby reduce my age further for the day. Yun lang, that is really my message because of the pressing problem. We cannot move ating sa economy unless we have enough, you know, there's not enough money to go around. So with the little effort and with the big assistance that we're getting, maybe I can plow back the money doon sa local governments. Sabi ko nga, it will be strictly equality. Total, I won by about 6 million. And that is representative also of the... Nalo ako dito kunti-kunti, pero pag inipon mo lahat, in a few, salanaw, landslide, hindi man ninyo alam. So ako na lang rin sabihin kung bakit. In the Muslim areas, even in Basilan and all, I won. Tawtawi, I won. Sa Bisaya, sa lahat man, lahat, halos lahat, except in a few areas. So I have to be true to the Filipino people. And I have to true to myself. Pagdating ng panahon, gaganon ka na. At least, pag alis ko, meron akong naipakita. Although it might not really be good for everybody, it might not meet the approval of the entire planet. Wrongly or rightly, at least may ginawa ako. Kung nagkamali nga ako, 10 angels of God swearing na tama yan, wala na. But I will do it because I am here. Maraming salamat.
Thank you very much, Mr. President, for your encouraging words.
And now, may we request the President for a photo opportunity? Batch 1 po is our PCL National Officers.
I promise somebody that I will